Hello, my friends. Once again, here from Valente Brothers headquarters. Last year, we made a post about training specificity, the concept of training specificity, and the fact that here in Valente Brothers, a while back, we decided to focus on 100% self-defense. That's our motto. And the idea that we don't teach any techniques that antagonizes this principle of training specificity. If our objective is to train our students to defend themselves, then we decided not to teach anything that our students would not use in a self-defense situation. And the question was if we could list some techniques. It's not about the techniques specifically. It's about our understanding of the techniques and deciding if those techniques can or cannot be used successfully in a fight. And whatever we believe cannot be used successfully in a fight, we do not teach in our school for any other purpose. And we have deep respect for people who prefer to train jiu-jitsu or any other martial art with different objectives, competition, sport, whatever it might be. Our objective is self-defense, and for that we teach techniques that can satisfy that purpose. And we speak of this here in the museum because we believe that this is in line with the history of jiu-jitsu, which begins even before the name jiu-jitsu was coined for the first time, even before jiu-jitsu was ever practiced in Japan, because fighting is about the human instinct. If you go back to ancient Egypt, to Mesopotamia, almost 5,000 years ago, you already find elements of jiu-jitsu, techniques of jiu-jitsu being practiced. In Japan, they decided to develop a martial art based on the Chinese principle of yielding, of non-resistance, the idea that strength can only be manifested with resistance. So how does a small person fight a bigger person? By not using strength, by avoiding strength and trying to use the strength of the attacker against the attacker. That's the idea of jiu-jitsu, is fighting with minimum strength and maximum result. And if you look at the origins of jiu-jitsu, these origins are in the battlefield, right? You see that the samurai warriors developed this system for the battlefield. And in the 17th century, when Japan, the tribal wars were not happening so much anymore, they started practicing jiu-jitsu for self-defense. And for the purpose of using these techniques in self-defense. With the Meiji Restoration, you see that jiu-jitsu needed to be adapted to modern times, and Jigoro Kano was a big figure in that. And then we can continue the history of jiu-jitsu through Europe and the Americas and the Western world, how it progressed in different ways. But the point is that, and that was the point of the post when we're talking about training specificity, the point of that post was that the human brain is going to react under pressure based on reflex, based on muscle memory. So the way you train is the way you fight. So for you to train one way and believe that you're going to react in a fight in a different way, wishful thinking. You can do that on the mat, on the comfort of your mat, but once you are fighting for your life, when you're threatened, this is, anybody who studies the human brain understands this, the fight or flight, the fact that you're going to be going 100% on instinct, on reflex, and this instinct, this reflex is created through training. And that's our philosophy at Valente Brothers, to create a training environment where students are training realistically, we spar, we train with resistance, we drill, we do all of that. But we focus on techniques which are useful for self-defense. And this is something that is also in line with our grandmasters, Carlos and Hélio Gracie, who really defended this idea in the early days, saying that there's several interviews, especially with Grandmaster Carlos in the early 30s, saying jiu-jitsu is not a sport. And they really dedicated their lives to promoting this idea. We, the Valente Brothers, are extremely happy when people from all over the world come to visit our school. The reason why we built this school is to preserve the history and to be able to share, not only with the jiu-jitsu community, but with anyone who really wants to learn jiu-jitsu as an art of self-defense. Recently, my brother Guy Valente was in Europe. He taught a seminar in Amsterdam, and he was very happy that people from all over Europe came to the seminar, and people from all over the world have been coming here to Miami, to our school. And we would like to extend an invitation to all of you who are watching this video. If you haven't yet been here in Miami, please come. It's going to be a pleasure to have all of you here on our mat. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day.